this video, you'll learn to draw this beautiful galaxy painting. So here are the materials that we will use in this tutorial. This is a masking tape which I used to hold down the paper. We need a flat brush and few round brushes to add in the details. And to paint our stars, we'll use a toothbrush. I would recommend that you use an old one unless you want colorful teeth. Coming on to the colors, we'll be mostly using different shades of blue, a little bit of green, yellow and pink. Don't worry if you don't have the exact color, you can use a matching shade from your palette. We'll be using a 300 GSM cold pressed watercolor paper for this, as it can hold a lot of water. It's a thick sheet of paper and has a really nice texture as well. So let's get started. First of all, we apply some water to the paper evenly. I left out the mountain area intentionally because we want to work on the sky first. Next, I'm using cerulean blue and painting at the corners almost randomly. Now I'm adding a bit of cobalt blue and it automatically blends in. This is a really bright shade of pink and will look really interesting later on. Now I'm adding a bit of yellow and green at the corner of the mountain to start building that glowing effect. Then you have to let it dry for some time. You can let it air dry, but I like to use a hairdryer to speed things up. Starting with the second layer now, we again apply some water to the surface, making sure to use the brush very lightly and cleaning it often. Otherwise, it can damage our first layer. Starting at the edges, I'm adding bright violet and some cobalt blue to add some vibrance. I keep on adding more water to the paper as necessary and apply more color at the edges to give it some depth. Now I'm applying some really dark sepia tone to add some contrast. And if you notice, I've kept the center almost white, adding very little color to it. This keeps a good balance between light and dark and creates a nice composition. Building up another layer now and starting again with applying some water. To correct any mistakes, you can use white tissue to absorb the paint like I did here. Now it's time to add even more depth to it, for which I use indigo blue. I use it really concentrated without diluting it much. And if you use watercolor tubes, you can directly get very rich pigment from there, which is what I also like to do. So now I'm working on adding more depth using indigo, while taking care of midtones using colors like cerulean and peacock blue. As you can see, I'm building another layer now, which is what I do a lot. With watercolor, it helps to work in layers, starting with lighter shades and then building up color intensity with each layer. Another important thing to note is that while applying water, I go from lighter area to dark to avoid any contamination. I'm adding more blue tones, keeping a balance of intensity. Don't worry too much about using the exact colors, just focus on lighter and darker areas and use the appropriate colors. Adding a little bit of viridian green alongside blue creates a nice ocean blue color. Now I'm adding bright pink and blending it evenly with the darker tones. Adding a bit of it in other areas helps with balance. I've also added a dash of red, which adds some emphasis on it. To finish the sky, I'm blending some harsh edges with water and adding some more pigment to required areas. Now coming onto the mountains, I'll be mostly using the flat brush and hold it at a sideways angle. It helps in switching easily from creating fine lines to broad strokes. For the color, I'm using gray and black mixed with a little bit of indigo to give it a bluish hue. As you can see here, I'm constantly switching from flat to thin sides of the brush. I'm mostly using the thin side to create the slope of the mountains and the flat side to add color. I'm using the same layering principle here as well, laying down a lighter shade first with lots of water mixed in and then adding more concentrated paint as we go further. Following this process, I ended up covering some areas that were supposed to be light. So I'm going in with some white paint and adding back the lighter areas. Now it's time to add some stars, and this is really exciting. For this, you can use an old toothbrush and directly apply white acrylic paint onto the bristles. Then gently flick the bristles to add the stars. For larger stars, you can apply white paint onto a regular round brush and tap it. Also, make sure you don't overdo it, because it's the most common mistake a lot of people make. At least I've done that in the past, so I would recommend that you try it out on a scrap piece of paper first, because we don't want to ruin our painting after coming so far, right? And so there you have it. Congratulations for making it to the end of the tutorial. Now go and make it on your own and leave a comment if you have any questions. I answer to all of them. If you like this, then give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe for more art and tutorials. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.